Hey guys, today I will show you how to compute the effective seismic weight of this structure using hand calculation, and then we will compare the results obtained using the hand calculation with ETABS results in order to ensure that we have computed correctly, okay? And the first thing that we need to determine here is to go to the define and the mass source. We need to determine the source of masses included in computing the effective seismic weight. And as shown here, I have included all the dead loads, which are the self-weight of the components and the superimposed dead load assigned to each floor. Okay, therefore, we need to compute the effective seismic weight using those two load patterns. Okay, jumping into our Excel sheet here, we need first to start providing the inputs here for those tables. Because first we need to know the geometry of those components in order to obtain the volume, and after obtaining the volume, we need to multiply it by the unit weight in order to obtain the weight, okay? This is actually the idea of this sheet called building weight and period. Of course, I name it building weight and period because here I have included the tables required for the model mass participation ratio. We will come back later for them, of course, but for now, let's focus here. For the slab data here, we need first to determine the area of the slab, the opening. Of course, I have opening in the location of the cores. The effective area is just the difference between the total area and the opening area. The slab thickness here is assumed to be 25 centimeters. The unit weight is changed to 24. Of course, if I go here to the define concrete material, we can check that I have used 24 kilonewton per cubic meter for the unit weight, okay? And for the superimposed dead load, I have assigned 2.5 kilonewton per square meter for each floor. And now for walls, we need to determine the parameters or the lengths of those cores and the thickness in order to obtain the volume. If I go to ETABS here, for example, if I set the plan view to story number 8, zooming here into this core, we can determine the lengths of this core by just saying that 2.5 multiplied by 4 segments. This will provide a 10 meter plus 6, it is 16, okay? Here I have used 16 meter for core number 1, 20 for core number 2. Of course, core number 3 and 4 are just similar to 1 and 2. Now for the table of the columns data, we need first to provide the cross-section dimension and the number of columns per each floor. The story height is 2.85 meter, the area of window is 1.8, and the area of the door is 2.25. And after filling or providing all of those required inputs, now we can compute the weight of each story using this table here. Of course, the one thing that I want to remind you about is that how ETABS lump the masses at the center of each floor. You can go to my YouTube channel to this video called Effective Seismic Weights, maybe lecture 9. I have provided here a detailed explanation of how to compute the effective seismic weight and even how ETABS lump the masses in which way. Of course, as shown here in this small figure, what ETABS do is just lump the masses from half of the weight of the story below and half of the weight of the story above into the floor itself under consideration, okay? Now we need to determine the slab weight is just equal to the effective area multiplied by the thickness by the unit weight. For columns, we need just to multiply the columns cross section by the number of columns multiplied by the height by the unit weight. For core number 1, it is the length by the height by the thickness by the unit weight. And for core 2, it's just the same. Here I have included additional cells because we need here to account for the opening area, okay? And similarly, if I go to the last row in this table, story number 8 is different from the rest of the other stories. The only difference here is just in the weight of the vertical components as shown in those cells. For example, for the first cell here, which is the column weight, I have divided the weight of the columns obtained here by 2 because I don't have columns in the above story, okay? And that's why I divided by 2. Similarly, for core number 1, I divided by 2. And for core number 2, I have computed the weight using the story height divided by 2 because it is here the last story, minus this value which I have obtained from AutoCAD actually. We need just to determine here the area of this small piece of the opening, okay? Therefore, don't rush, just the area multiplied by E12, which is the thickness, multiplied by the unit weight, okay? And now after computing the weight of the structural components of each story, we need to go to this table. For example, the weight of the story number 8 is just equal to the summation of those cells here. Similarly, for story number 7, it is equal to the summation of those cells. And of course, we should get the same weight per story for those stories between story number 1 and 7, because they have the same cross-section dimensions and lengths. Okay, now the summation of those cells provide the total dead weight of the structure, or the effective seismic weight. And in the same manner, if we want to obtain the mass by story, we can just convert the weights obtained here by dividing them into this value, okay? Therefore, we have obtained the effective seismic weight of the structure by summing those cells, and we need now to check our hand calculation with ETABS results. And now to obtain the mass summary by story, we need to go to ETABS to this option shown here. I have right the procedure of obtaining the mass summary by story. We need to go to display, show tables, other definitions, mass data, mass summary by story. As shown here, the unit is kilogram. We need to divide by 1000 in order to obtain them as ton. We need to copy those values to here. Okay. As shown here, the difference of what we have computed and what ETABS provide us is just 10 kilonewton, which is equal to 1 ton. This is a minor difference actually. 1 ton is nothing. And we can say that the difference is accepted actually. But I can guarantee for you that the true value of the seismic weight is the one obtained using the hand calculation. Because I have tried before, if I go to ETABS and I remove the mesh of the slab elements, I will get the same value here of the seismic weight obtained using the hand calculation, okay? Also, the one thing that I want to remind you about, if we assign the mesh for walls from this option here, from the assign shell wall auto mesh option, we will get wrong results or wrong values of masses obtained from ETABS, because ETABS will lump the masses in wrong way at the center of each story, okay? And this is actually the reason of dividing the walls, or to do the manual mesh of the wall rather than assigning the mesh for walls using the wall auto mesh option. Now, the last thing that we need to do is to obtain the mass summary by diaphragm. And the one thing that I want you to notice, I'm obtaining the results from this model and with 0.7 IG, okay? In this model, I have assigned the mesh for the slab elements using the option inside ETABS, and I have divided the walls rather than assigning the mesh from the wall auto mesh option. Okay, now we need to select here the second choice, and we need to copy those results to Excel. I will divide by 1000 to convert them to ton. Now we need to copy them to here. And as shown here, we have a major difference in the weight computed and the weight provided by ETABS. And there is a solution for this. We can make the difference equal to zero, actually. I have right here a comment that shows you how to do it. We need first to remove the slab mesh, and we need to do manual mesh for the slab and wall elements, and they should be connected. Therefore, you need to just guarantee that all the slab and wall elements are connected to each other in a good way, okay? This is called actually manual mesh. We can divide any segment into many small pieces, and this is called manual mesh. But of course, it is easier to assign a mesh rather than dividing the system into smaller pieces, because we will get at the end many elements inside the model, and this will affect on the time needed in running the analysis, okay? Also, I have included a hint or a note on how to assign diaphragm from joint option. You can read it by yourself. And the last thing I want to mention for you about the diaphragm masses here, the one we have obtained from ETABS, they are actually not used inside the computation of the seismic forces. This value will be used inside ETABS, therefore we can say that this value is accepted and very close to the one that we have computed manually. Okay, the last thing I want to show you, I will go now into different ETABS model. We have saved it before here in a folder called Perform. In this model, I didn't use any mesh for the slab elements, and I will use this model at the end of this tutorial in order to import it into Performance 3D, as I have told you before, okay? Therefore, I didn't use any mesh for the walls or the slab elements, and I will try now to obtain the masses from this model in order to show you what I exactly mean. We need to go to the other definition, mass data, mass by story. Let's copy those values to Excel. We need to sum them. Maybe let me just copy the format of those cells. Okay, those values are in kilogram. We need to divide by 1000. Let's repeat this one here to here. I will copy those as a values. Let me delete those. As shown here, now we have obtained the same effective seismic weight from ETABS, same as the one that we have computed manually. Therefore, we have obtained the exact or the same mass computed manually from ETABS model, which doesn't have any assigned mesh to the slab or the wall elements. And we need also to ensure that the components of this model are well connected to each other, okay? This is the end of this tutorial. I hope you find it useful and stay tuned for my next video.